Hi, my name's David, and I'll be playing the first movement of Mozart's Clarinet Concerto.
I'm Kevin Schempf at Bowling Green State University, and this is the first time I've heard you play in about 3 years.
Yeah.
Can you feel how the air moves through the clarinet better? Yeah, I think it's a lot better that way. You do a couple things which don't help your air. For example, even the way you use your body, it kind of confines the air.
Okay.
I wouldn't make quite as many motions as you do.
Okay.
The second thing is I notice when you use a straw and when you play, as soon as you play fast notes, you play louder.
Okay.
I don't think I do that.
Okay.
Play louder where you think the phrase goes, not just where, you know, it's hard.
Okay.
But there's something we should spend some time with your embouchure,
right,
because that's the same thing that's obstructing your air. I need you to sit down to do this. Your embouchure is better than it was when I saw you a couple years ago, but it's still not steady. Especially when you cross the break, your chin comes up and it doesn't hold its position. To play the clarinet, all we really need to do is blow into it. That's the first order of business. So you can rest it on your legs, hands on your legs.
Completely comfortable and just blow.
To get sound out, we have to add enough pressure so that the reed will get close enough to the mouthpiece to vibrate. There are two ways we can do it. We can clamp in, like a crab, or we can lift the mouthpiece reed into our embouchure. So your embouchure stays still. When you pull the clarinet into it, you get the pressure and the sound comes out, and when you drop it out, the sound stops. So keep your mouth open when you drop it out.
Yeah.
So to play the clarinet, all you need to do, I said this a while ago, is have love in your heart and